Hi guys, this is JJ Lockhart back again this week with a new video. This week I'm doing something a little bit different. I'm going to give you guys an art haul video. And this is going to be my first one, so bear with me. I just decided to do something like this week because over the holidays and over the last couple of months, I've been acquiring a lot of different art materials, either for, you know, just art or craft. So I just wanted to share with you what I've been using lately. So I guess to start off with, the first thing is this actual mat cutting board. I just recently got that. I actually got it as a Christmas present. On one side, you can see the grid is white, and on the other side, the grid is black. So I generally just keep it on the white side, but I like that I have that variety. But it's also really nice and nice clean. I haven't gotten any paint on it yet, which is odd. And I like that it's a nice neutral color. It's not too bright and it's not too dark. So I've been using that as a background lately, and I really enjoy it. Another thing that I received as a gift was these Prismacolor color erase pencils. I did have individuals that I had purchased here and there. I usually purchase the red or the blue, but this 24-pack has a variety of colors, and I've already been using them. They're not all in here because some of them are here and there, but I've already started using them, and I absolutely love these. And it's so awesome that now I have so many colors to play with. So I got that as a gift as well. So I'm very excited about that. And let's see. I also received this small watercolor set. Now, this is a very simple little watercolor set, and the reason why I wanted it was because it's a nice little palette, and as you can see, there isn't too much watercolor, like, paints in each of the little wells, but that's actually a good thing because I plan to use these, and once I'm done with them, I want to fill it up with my, what are those called? My opaque, some other paints that I got in tubes. I'll insert the name here because I don't remember what they're called. But I have these other paints that I have received, and so I want to fill those in the wells here. And so this was a nice cheap alternative because instead of buying a palette on its own, which sometimes can be very expensive, this one already has some paint in it. I can use it, and then I'll refill them in with the paints that I want in there, which I have in tubes. Also, another cool thing about this is it came with some brushes, but also if you look on this side, the individual well parts of the palette are actually raised, so I could even use this to mix colors in there. Also, I know that when I put my paints in here, that they'll be secure and they're not going to be moving around too much. So I'm very excited about this little palette, and once I haven't started using it yet, but once I do and use up the colors, I'll probably just go in and put the other paints that I have that I want to refill in here. So I'm very excited about that. And I like that there's a place for the brushes, so that way I can even take it on the go. So that's a nice option. And then some other things that I've sort of purchased here and there. The Tuesday morning near our house had a sale on these Pro Markers. I guess because they're Electroset, I guess that brand's still on there. And of course, now it's Winsor Newton, so these markers are no longer available. So Tuesday morning had them, and they had a whole bunch of them, and of course I stocked up. They had them there essentially for $1 a pen, so that's really cheap. I think these usually go for like 5 to 7 each. So I got them $1 each, and I was just so excited. So I hit up all of the, local Tuesday mornings and just stocked up. And they did have different kinds. They also had the water-based ones, But I'm obviously not interested in a water-based one because otherwise I'd just pick up, you know, Crayola or something else. So they did have these, and I'm very excited. They have the alcohol-based ones. They have the regular ones, which have two nibs. You can see here, this one has a chisel nib on one side and then a bullet nib on the other side. So they don't have the brush tip, but they're still really good markers. And then they also had the flex markers, which do have the brush tip nib, sort of. And then they have a chisel. So I was very excited to see that they had a variety of them. So obviously, I didn't pick up the water-based ones. I only picked up the alcohol-based ones. So I picked up a variety of these, the whatever that they had, I pretty much picked up. And so some of the colors, I think I got like, I think I only duplicated like two because they sold them in packs. But I thought that's not bad. So I got a variety of them. I have a whole bunch here. I don't think this is even all of them. But I got all of these pretty much. And they also had the metallic ones. So they also had, this one's a copper. They also had, I think, gold and silver. So I was very excited to see that. So they had metallic ones. They all, like I said, they had the flex ones, which have the brush tip on them. And then they had the regular ones. So I got a variety of colors. So I was very excited to see them. And I've actually already started playing around with them. And I really like the colors that I got, surprisingly. There's some of the colors I haven't tried yet. Like, for example, I'm not really big on orange. So I haven't really used that yet because I don't normally use too much orange. Red I do use. I just haven't had a chance to use these. I have used a lot of the blues, the purples, and they're really nice. The ink's really nice, smooth. They go well into the paper. I haven't had any complaints yet. Even the ones that have a chisel nib, even just using the chisel nib is pretty fun. You just cover a lot of area, and if there's anything small, you just cover it obviously with the little bullet, the bullet side. But very cool, and I was so excited that they had them on sale for $1 a marker. Of course, I had to pick up all the colors that I could get my hands on. Something else, oh yeah, Tuesday morning I also picked up this Tattered Angel Shimmer Mist. I've never seen or used this before, but I thought I'd give it a try. It was on sale also, and essentially it's just like, it's in a mister spray bottle, and it says that you can just add a fine shimmer or mist by misting it onto anything that you want. It is water, it's not alcohol based, so I thought I'd give it a try. I have tried it a couple of times, and I don't really see too much of a shimmer to whatever I mist, and it does have a blue tint to it. You can tell by the water, but also when you mist it, the water does have like a blue tint to it. It's not incredibly shiny or shimmery or glittery, but I need to play around with it a little bit more before I decide whether I like it or not. But if I do, they did have other colors and different style, you know, different shimmer and water colors to try out. So if I do like it, I might pick up some more. The only thing is, like I said, it is a water-based product, so we'll see what I can play around with it, but that's something else I picked up there. I know, I don't know if you guys have watched my art studio tour. If you did, great. If you didn't, I'll have a link to the video in the description. But in the video tour, in the art room tour, I had one of these boxes that was empty. I have a whole row of these boxes, and they're all filled with little gadgets and bits. And so I had one that was empty. So I found something to put in there. Like I said, I probably would fill it up quick. But I found, what I did is I grabbed a whole bunch of stamp stuff. And a lot of these come from Tuesday Morning also. Some of them are from Target. My daughter and I, we love to just sit there and stamp stuff. She really likes it. She's 4 years old right now, so she loves to stamp stuff. So we decided to get some stamping stuff together. And these have a date and like little comments on them. And I thought those would be great for my sketchbook. So I could just, you know, stamp, you know, the date I sketched something or a little funny note or something. I thought these would be cute. So I have two of these with the different, with the date and everything and with a little little comments on there. So I have two of those. And then I also picked up these from Tuesday Morning. They're like little inkers. If you open it, you can, they've just got like a little ink pad on there. And you can, like, for example, here, if I wanted only like, you know, the first couple, you know, maybe if I just wanted the month and not the year, I can go in there and put the ink directly on where I want it and then stamp it. So that's kind of nice. I don't have to stamp it in a whole big ink pad. And they have different colors. I picked up these two. It looks like three per. So I picked this one and I picked this one up. This one has pink, orange, yellow. This one has purple, green, and blue. So I thought, oh, that's pretty cool. And it's easy to take. So, you know, if I'm traveling, if I want to take a stamp with me or, you know, take some stamps with my daughter, I can just put these in a bag and be good to go. I don't need to take a whole big ink pad. So I got these. Then I got these I got for Target, and these are really nice. They're Valentine's Day themed, but I thought they were really cute, and Kim, my daughter and I use them for a lot of different things. And as you can see, I've already started using them. I have a gold ink pad, which I'll show you guys in a little bit, that I use this on. So that's why some of them are black and some of them are gold. But I thought they were pretty cute. And my daughter obviously loves them. And then I have some other ones that I've picked up randomly. I think they had these at Walmart. They just had them on sale as a little pack. And I thought they were cute. And my logo and what I go with is usually a heart. And I thought that was cool. There was a heart, a nice big heart. So I can stamp things with that. And I really like this one. It's like a pattern. It's really pretty. So I've got those. And then, as far as ink pads, I have all of this. These we picked up at Target, and they had nice, pretty colors. I really like these two colors, and then this one I use for stuff that I put my logo on. Like, for example, if I ink something with a heart, I usually use this. And then, as you can see, it's a little bit dirty already because my daughter got into it and cross-contaminated. Ah. But anyway, she's only four, so of course she wouldn't know. This is my gold ink, and I've actually had this one for a while, and it still works really well. I don't remember where I picked this up, but it's really nice, and it's actually gold ink. Like, it's actually gold, which I love. And then I had this one, so it's just regular black. And then I also picked this one up at Tuesday Morning. It was also on sale, and it's just regular black ink. Nice big pad. So I did pick up that recently. And then these are more for my daughter just because they're self-inking. But they just, you know, stamp. And it says, very nice, great job, you rule, and yes, you can. So these are nice. And she plays around with these mostly because she doesn't have to, you know, put it in and stamp. They're self-inking. So these are for her. And we picked these up at Target also. And then one more thing. I also got this stamp. And it just says special delivery, first class mail. And I really liked how it looked. And it came with its own red ink as well. So I'll probably use that for shipping. Because hopefully I will be opening my my online store soon. So I'll probably be using that for that. So that's everything that was in this little box. And most of this stuff is new because I didn't really have anything for stamping. And then my daughter just absolutely loves it. And so I thought, well, you know, I should fill this box up with a whole bunch of cool stamp stuff. So that was that. I also got some new brushes. And this I got from AC Moore. It's our local, art supply store. And it was just a packet of five different brushes. I like that they were nice and simple. And I like the type of brush it is. They're like just rounds. I didn't have any round ones. I have a lot of flat brushes. But I didn't have too many round ones or smaller round ones. So I picked these up. And I like this type of bristle, they're not real hair, synthetic hairs, I guess. I like those just because they're smoother. So I've been using these for some watercolor stuff and some acrylic stuff, but mostly watercolor because they're nice big round brushes. So I got these. I also got Actually, I forgot to mention that while I was at Tuesday Morning, I also got this really big pack of cardstock. I guess it's intended for crafting, but I really liked all the colors that were in there. And it's got so much paper, and I think they're all cut at an 8x8, and I've actually been using this for some artwork too. And what I like about it is that it's nice, sturdy paper. It's not too thick and not too cushiony, so I can actually use my markers on them, and they look really nice. There is some bleed through, but it doesn't soak up all of the ink, and it looks really nice. And I like that it's different colors, so I've actually been playing with using other, you know, working on different tones, different tone paper. So I got this big stack, and I just love the size of it and all the colors that were in there and the amount. And it was very inexpensive. So I grabbed that also at Tuesday Morning because that was on sale there as well. And let's see, there's only a couple of other things that I've purchased. I know that was already a whole bunch, but this stuff is actually from the Dollar Tree. I'll line it up. I grabbed some really inky pens. These are really nice. The tip is really, really fine, and they're very inky. So I was very excited to see them there at the Dollar Tree, two for a dollar. I also found these permanent markers at the Dollar Tree. One side's a little bit, you know, thin. They're both fine, but this one's a little bit thicker, and then the other side's a little bit thinner. It's more like felty, and it's kind of hard to see the size of them here. But I really like these. I haven't used them yet, but I thought this would be interesting. You know, they're permanent markers, so I can, you know, give those a try. And then they also had these really fine pen. They're like really, really thin-tipped pens. And they had them in packs of three, so I just picked up one of each pack that I saw. The only color I'm really missing is purple that I care about. You know, obviously there's lots of other colors, but I did notice that there was no purple. I was like, I'll just have to find a purple elsewhere. But I do really like that they're really, really fine. And the paper set and the carton that they were in, which they're already out of, it said that they are non-smudging and they don't fade. So I thought this would be great since they're really, really fine for details. So when I use my, my Pro markers or my Copic markers, and then I can go in there with a little bit more detail with these colors when I'm drawing. So I thought, well, it'd be interesting to give it a try. And then the last thing from the Dollar Tree is these really big mechanical pencils. Now the lead on them is 2.0 millimeters, so it's actually really thick lead. It comes with lead inside of the pencil, and they also come with the extra. And then also, if you look real close, the eraser part is not actually eraser, it's actually a little sharpener, so you can get the tip of the lead really, really fine. And I thought that it was interesting that they had the two colors that I usually use, red and blue, because those are the ones that I use the most for sketching. And so I picked this up. I was like, for a dollar, that's wonderful. So since I usually sketch with red and blue, I grabbed this, and that way I can sketch with a really big, you know, I guess a thicker, because usually I sketch with the Prismacolor erase ones. But I thought this was a good alternative, and it's cheaper. Try it out, see if I like them. If I do, I'll probably go pick up some more. But I thought I'd give these a try. And then, so that's all for the Dollar Tree. And then the last thing I have really is more like, I guess, office supplies are not really art. I guess I could still use them for art, but I guess I intended it more to be for office supplies. And I got this from Target also. These are so cute. First, I got these. It was a pack for a dollar, and they're three little mechanical pencils. But they were so cute, and they look like little pencils, and they're, you know, I have small hands, so these are really cute and small, and the print on them is adorable. The other thing is that they were a dollar for three of them, but they had all their winter items on sale. I think it was like 90% off, and these, I guess, are considered winter because of the pattern, and so they ended up being like 10 cents, and it was just like, wow, I got super super lucky, and I just came in on the right day, and I didn't even notice. And then they just have regular, it's just a mechanical pencil. I'm not sure what size that is. If I were to guess, probably 0.7 size. But I have plenty of extra, you know, lead for mechanical pencils because that's usually what I use to draw. So I guess I intended these as, you know, office supplies and art because I sketch with mechanical pencils anyways. And then these are so cute. These are pens, but they look like pencils. And they just have like, this one's pink and rose gold striped. And this one is white with rose gold splotches, I guess. But I thought that was so cool. They look like pencils, but they're pens. And then the tips are like gold. And then they just are write regular black ink. So I thought that was cute. So I think that's about all I got. That, I mean, I guess seemed like a lot. But a lot of them were like Christmas presents and stuff that I'd been, you know, picking up here and there in the last couple of months. So thank you guys for watching. I hope this video wasn't ridiculously long, but stay tuned. I usually have a new art video up every week, and thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.